righty, welcome back, everybody. It is the Tim Conway Jr. Show live at 97.1 FM Talk. Arsenio Hall is with us.
Yep, yep.
And we're going to try to get Arsenio Hall down to the January 15th Commerce Casino Poker Tournament. It's always the best remote that we do for the listeners.
Oh, okay. Now, why is that?
Well, because I think a lot of listeners enjoy playing poker and gambling and smoking and drinking.
Your demo, even the children gamble.
Yes. Isn't that right?
A 12-year-old just called us from the Luxor.
Yes. Where he's come.
He's a whale.
But it always is a great tournament. And Dave Mosikian and Ralph Mosikian, all the people.
I know that last name.
Mosikian?
Yeah.
Yeah, they're part of the bigwigs over at Commerce Casino.
Okay, are they Indians?
No, I think they're Armenians.
Oh, Mosikian?
Mosikian, yeah.
Well, that sounds like they got money.
Yeah, oh, jeez, you wouldn't believe it. But anyway, it's always a great tournament. You got to sign up on the website. And if you sign up tonight, chances are fairly decent, pretty good, you'll get in, but I can't guarantee anything, you know. But you go to 971fmtalk.com and sign up for this thing.
Tim, if they don't sign up, they still can come, like, to meet Gina or...
Oh, yeah, you can come down. I don't know if you can play, but you can come down and meet Gina, and Gina will be signing autographs. Teresa Strauss will be there.
I was fortunate enough at one remote to come and meet Randy's mom.
Oh, yeah, Pam Wang.
Oh, boy.
Pamela Wang.
She's cute.
Yeah, no, she's the best.
Pam her Wang. She's the cutest dude. That's how old I am. It's like I work with people and their moms look good to me.
Well, but his mom's probably your age.
Exactly.
I really didn't want to go into this, but yes.
You could have a kid that old.
Oh, man. Okay, anyway. Because I probably do and you're bumming me out.
I would, if it wasn't for a certain procedure, and I won't talk about what it is because there's a youngin' around us, I would have had a 24-year-old.
Oh, really?
Yeah. 2'4". Well, 1 year older than Randy Wang. Imagine how depressed that'd be.
And SoCon would have a problem.
All right, folks. If you're familiar with the format of this program, you'll know that every single night we try to do news around 9 o'clock. It's about 5 after 9 right now with our own Gina Grett, everybody.
Yes, Lord. Now, from the 97.1 newsroom,
Gina Grett.
Here's Gina Grett with the news.
Because that's my fun day. Thank you for that applause.
All
that was really
that is
quite
your
welcoming.
Fun day, huh?
I love Mondays.
All righty.
Yes.
What's going on with the news?
Well, with New Year's Eve now behind us, it's time to reflect on what could possibly be considered the most inappropriate New Year's broadcast of the 2009 transition.
Oh, boy.
Yes, in this clip, host Anderson Cooper attempts to go to commercial as comedian and co-host Kathy Griffin viciously attacks a heckler attending the CNN broadcast.
All right. And this is on live.
Yeah, it's pretty crazy. And it was not edited at the time.
All right.
Yeah.
A.C. Cooper and Kathy Griffin. Here we go.
We've got to take
a
short break.
No,
we'll take a short break. I'll go to Bourbon
Shut
Street.
Shut up! You know what? Screw you! I'm working!
I'll be right back.
Why don't you get a job, buddy? You know what? I'm going to go to your job and knock the out of your mouth.
Oh, boy.
Jesus Christ.
She stole my line. It's my favorite joke.
Man. And knock the blank out of your mouth?
Yeah. Well,
I don't go to your job and knock the out of your mouth.
Oh, jeez.
When Gina says that, she means it.
Yeah,
man.
Wow.
She sounds like she's got a temper there.
I really try not to, honestly. But she, I don't know if I can say what she said. I obviously can't say what she said.
Yeah, and does it start with a B?
No.
A D?
Yes. Plural.
A P?
Yeah.
Oh, I see. All right.
Plurals.
You know what? I don't go to your job and knock the out of your mouth.
No, plural.
And CNN, they're so spontaneous and fun. They loved that.
She was wacky. They love wacky and zany.
All right, AC/DC and Kathy Griffin. All right, what else going on in the news?
Well, the Huffington Post reported this week that rock wife Sharon Osbourne lashed out at a Rock of Love Charm School contestant on the reunion show. This aired Sunday night. Megan Hauserman first filed a police report claiming Sharon grabbed her hair, scratched her, and pulled out her weave.
Oh, boy.
Megan insulting Sharon's husband, Ozzy Osbourne, after Sharon told Megan she should not procreate, as one of her is more than enough. And in this clip, Sharon stands up, pretends to take a sip of water, and then pours it over Megan's head.
Oh, jeez. I got to look at reality TV more. It's interesting. All right, here is Sharon Osbourne.
I think that one of you is enough for any country.
Actually, so does your husband, because the only thing you've managed to do to the celebrity is to wash your husband's
I feel so sorry. Excuse me before I answer.
Let's have professional acting.
You okay?
Yeah, let's have practice.
I heard that.
Yeah, then she throws her whole drink right in woman's face.
An electric pink red drink.
Oh, boy. And then they started fighting, huh?
Yeah, started pulling hair.
Let's see if we can hear any of that.
Let's have practice.
You know, it actually sounds like Christmas morning when I was a kid. And my mom came downstairs. This is really what it sounded like at the Conway house.
With Sharon Osbourne. We're going to try to figure this whole circus out.
Is that Ricky Rackman?
Ricky Rackman, yes.
God,
with
damn
a,
it!
A nice clean haircut with Ricky Rackman.
You guys know him?
Yeah.
Get your freaking act together here!
Yeah, Ricky Rackman was on the station when Steckler and I started here. And Steckler and Ricky Rackman had an altercation.
Oh.
Yeah.
Now who won that?
I guess there was like two real losers in it.
Oh.
If that's possible.
Okay.
Ricky had kept referring to Steckler as Dorf Jr. and the old man. That's what he kept calling the show, right? And Steckler didn't like the reference, the old man. So he, on the air, went nuts on Ricky Rackman, insulting him and his girlfriend at the time.
Wait, I read about this. Didn't Ricky Rackman, didn't his career end because of this? Or
his
something?
Radio career did,
okay,
yeah.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, and then he came in the next day. And I thought it was just on the air, and they were, you know, fighting on the air. Mm-hmm. And he said, where is Steckler? I said, oh, he's in the back room. And he didn't seem like, you know, he seemed like he was pretty level-headed. And went back there. And literally punched out Steckler.
Oh my God!
In the station, and hit him in the gave him a huge black eye that was bleeding. Punched out glasses.
How big is this Ricky kid?
he's not huge, but he works out.
You make it sound like it happened by the bike rack. Yeah. How big is this Ricky kid?
Well, you know what? I've seen these reunion shows where he hosts them, and. He didn't look to me like the kid that knocks people out and gives people black eyes.
I think
eyes.
He's scrappy. I think he's probably a decent fighter.
Mm-hmm.
But anyway, so he punches Steckler, throws a megaphone at him, hits him in the back, and somebody calls the cops. So the cops show up at the station, and LAPD come to the station, and they were there literally within like 2 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
And one of the cops said to me, and this guy was, this cop was about 6'7". About 230 pounds and wow. All muscle.
Ding, ding.
And he says to me, he says, who's Ricky Rackman? And I said, he's that guy over there. And he says, put your hands on your head. And Ricky says, no, I can explain. And the cop says, I don't give a rat's ass what the explanation is. You're going downtown.
Yeah.
And handcuffs and out the station.
Wow. You know the guy you call old? Well, because you hit him, you're going to jail.
You know, I saw something today. Speaking of LAPD, I was on Wilbur near Oxnard, and I saw a guy grab a woman by her jacket, about to punch her, but yelling at her, right? And I'm like, oh, I got to call the cops. This guy's going to, you know, this guy's huge. He's going to, you know, knock the hell out of this girl.
Mm-hmm.
As I'm about to call the cops, I see two LAPD cop cars in my rearview mirror.
Mm-hmm.
They both come up and, like, do like a... like a Starsky and Hutch screech.
Oh, surround.
Yeah, they stopped there.
Mm-hmm.
And I wasn't close enough, but they yelled something at him. And this big, tough guy turned into like this sort of wimpish guy.
Yeah, AC/DC.
It wasn't so tough when the law was there with the guns.
Johnny Law.
I was coming down Franklin. I told my son, I said, that's where the Magic Castle is. And I pointed up. And just as I looked left in that direction, a man walked up behind another man in front of a little hotel there and slammed a cinder block over his head.
Tonight that happened?
No. This was a couple weeks ago.
Oh, I say a couple weeks ago.
Broke the cinder block over his head and walked away.
Wow.
And
maybe that was a magic act.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
Yeah.
It's a fake brick.
I think if you come to later in the act, he makes the cinder brick go back together. You
know? And a bunny jumps out of it.
Exactly.
Yeah.
All right. What else is going on in the news there, Gina?
Well, we have some good news for us radio folk here, as 97.1 FM talk ratings are looking quite strong lately.
Yes, I saw that.
The data from the Portable People Meter, which is a unique audience measurement system that tracks what consumers listen to on the radio, has been looking very strong for KLSX, even with other stations dominating the airwaves with Christmas music the past couple weeks. So we're all very excited about that.
Yeah, I saw that Tom Likas in some demographics is like number two.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
With like men 25-54 and Frosty, Heidi, and Frank, they are number one with persons 25-54. Who makes 75,000 plus every year. They got a 7.2 share, or 7.2 rating, something like that.
Hey, Frank Kramer here.
Yeah.
Before I start work with you, when I would listen in the car, I always thought at moments like that you were reading. It's amazing what you have in your cerebellum. You know, you just spew off. So how do you?
Well, those are the things you like to remember.
Oh, okay,
you know,
when
it's a 1.3. You don't like to remember those numbers.
Yeah, yeah.
But this station, I mean, all the way through, and I think the 6 day helps. I mean, we're now on Saturday, and the ratings on the station are really going through the roof. It's unbelievable.
And you're here Sundays.
Yeah, you're Sunday with Dave Harden for Mortgage Matters. So there's something for everybody all 7 days.
Nice job, retard.
Even the weekend programming, even Sundays are up. Everybody loves listening to those shows.
Yes, Gina.
Yes, Tim.
Everybody loves it. When is the Russian lady who finds chicks for
Svetlana?
You?
Midnight on Saturday.
Yes.
Okay.
I actually co-hosted with her on Saturday night. I had nothing to do, and she invited me on the show.
Yeah?
Yeah. Hung out with her on Saturday.
Was it fun?
A lovely time, man.
It's good.
Yeah, Svetlana.
Call me from Vegas, but you didn't call me. You didn't call me. Oh, I'm sorry. Oh,
okay.
Oh, I forgot. I might have used the word I'm not supposed to use.
God damn it.
Sorry, Jack.
Yeah. Hey, Jack, sorry about that. Please.
God.
All right.
Let me just listen to the news.
What else is going on with that news there, baby?
Well, there is one overseas automaker out there that is not ignoring the downturning economy right now. Hyundai is actually making it easier for customers who suddenly can't afford their cars anymore by implementing their customer assurance program, which is run by a company called Walkaway USA. This is where customers can return their car and walk away without losing any money. The program essentially provides insurance for the first year after purchase. So if that car owner loses their job, files for bankruptcy, becomes disabled, they can return the car to the dealer. The program pays the difference between the vehicle's value and the dealer's buyback price up to $7,500. And Hyundai is now providing this incentive free with every new car sold.
Wait a minute. So you buy a car, and if you can't afford it, you just give it back
to them?
They
buy it back.
For the same price?
Well, it's some fuzzy math.
Oh, I see. Okay.
but they're trying to help the people out there. A Hyundai spokesperson talks a little bit about attacking consumers' buying fears.
Ah.
In this clip.
You know, speaking of auto sales, Chrysler was down, you know, like 57% or 47% or whatever. Ford was down. General Motors. Everybody's down. Toyota, Honda. But the one car company that actually sold more cars in 2008 than 2007?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, nothing. Subaru.
Oh.
And I have a Subaru. Thank you very much.
Yeah.
They were up like 0.7%.
Well, I got to tell you, I have a Hyundai, and I don't want to give it back. I'm a big fan.
Yeah, it's almost paid off, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, a couple more payments. How many more?
Zero more.
That's it? You made the last payment?
It's done. Well,
Mazel tov.
The royal we made the last payment, yes. And we're all very, very pleased.
Good for you. Congratulations. You own a car.
Thank you. That car is bionic. That car has been rebuilt like the phoenix from the ashes. So.
All right. Anything else going on in the
news?
Well,
we have a clip of a gentleman from Hyundai talking about attacking those consumer fears.
Oh, okay. All right. Here's a car company guy.
Yeah. We've got traditional kind of incentives out there right now, but people are not using those. They just don't want those because they're stuck on the couch because they got too much fear about their future income. So the program is really geared to attack that basic fear that people have in their head.
I see.
There you go.
Right. Buy a car and return it.
It's like a library.
And that doesn't kill your credit rating, huh?
Well, they don't say.
Oh, I see. Okay. All right.
You asked the hard-hitting questions,
though.
Thank
you very much. Thank you. Thank
that's
much.
Why you're on every day.
Right.
In some form or another. Yeah. You're tasting wine.
Exactly.
You're giving advice every day.
Yes. He's not tasting wine. That's for damn sure.
Tasting vodka. And if I'm not here, they just play the best of the show. But
actually, that didn't happen.
What?
We ran a best of Adam Carolla and Tom Likas and Frosty and Frank during this slot.
I knew after that pregnant.
Yeah, for 2 weeks. And then Sammy came in a couple days.
Yeah. Mm. With Jeff Conaway.
Sure. Right, and somebody else, too, right?
A couple other.
Kid from Kid and Play.
That's what I heard about.
Sure.
Yes.
All right. Excellent. Well, I hope they kept the ratings up. All right. Anything else going on in the news there?
Yes. Well, finally, as many L.A. motorists know, it is already illegal for California drivers to talk on a handheld cell phone while behind the wheel, as I know for sure. And as of January 1, if you get caught texting while driving, you will have to pay the price. Princess doesn't like that. Not at all. Princess already got hit for that one. For a first offense, the ticket will cost you $20. Get caught again, the fine jumps to $50. And while not all motorists are happy about being told when and where they can text, many drivers said the streets will be safer after the new law takes effect. And just a quick warning to drivers, unlike when the last cell phone law went into effect, there will be no grace period. Officers said they have already begun issuing tickets for the texting.
Now, how does somebody know if you're texting, though?
Because while everybody else is going, your head is tilted down.
Yeah, but if you're dialing a phone number, you can't dial a phone number?
Someone also told me, and maybe someone can clear this up, you're not allowed to hold a phone in your hand.
So, get out of here.
Because I would always talk with my speakerphone on and just sort of have it on the wheel while I was driving, but I was told I'm not even allowed to show that it's in my hand.
Jesus
wow.
Christ.
So.
I usually like to bring an old rotary phone, sit on my lap, and challenge the cop. You know,
it's use
like,
the crank.
What? It's a phone, yeah, technically. Now take me to jail.
Hold on. Brighton 425, please.
That's amazing, though. What are you, that dumb law?
Yeah.
So you can't text. But what about guys? You're the same. I haven't seen you do this, but you said you can do it, so I'll take your word for it.
Yeah.
But like Jerry Wachowski, who used to work with us, he can text without looking
at
his phone.
Never look down, yeah.
Can you do the same thing?
Well, who can't?
I can't.
Well, you know who do you know who John Sally is?
Yes.
John Sally, wonderful basketball player. He's actually
Detroit?
Played on more. Yeah, Detroit, Chicago, L.A. He's been everywhere, has rings from everywhere. I saw John Sally on Best Damn Sports during a commercial work two Blackberries.
Wow.
One in each hand, and he had his thumb going, and I'm like, yo, pimp, you my hero. From now on, it's John Sally, then Martin Luther King. I saw him texting. It was amazing, Tim. It was amazing.
You know, I witnessed this when Jerry, I told him to type something, and I would see how quickly he could do it. He sat there and never looked at his phone and typed it out, but using all caps and punctuation and periods and exclamation points, all that stuff, and it did it without looking at it. And got the thing 100% correct. You can do
it. I have a job!
I don't mean to call you out, but it actually almost makes you sound a little bit dated. To be like, do you know that there are people that can text without looking down?
I was just about to say, yeah, these kids.
Yeah, exactly.
The only joke is that me and Tim are really old.
With those newfangled phones.
Yeah. Oh, my word.
So you can do that.
Yes. I mean, my keypad's a little harder than Jerry's was. When I had Jerry's,
here
it was...
the excuses.
No. I mean, I can still do it, but I have, like, a keyboard now. It was easier when you have the classic phone when it's like... The 2 is A, B, and C, and the 3 is D, E, and F. That's easier, but yes, I can do it.
You know what we should do is at the Commerce Casino, we should have a contest. Like over the next couple weeks, solicit people who are really good at texting.
Yeah.
And see if, who the fastest texter is. Is it a texter?
I guess so.
Texty?
A texter.
Texterman? who the fastest texter is in all of Southern California. And give that young man a prize.
That's a good
idea. But that's it is amazing how you can do that. Because I've got to look at the phone and then hit, you know, 1, 2, 3. Okay, there's a D. 1, 2, 3, 4. There's a Y. One, and I can't do it.
I'll text him like a novella, like a really long message, and I'll get back like 12 minutes later, yeah, but it's spelled wrong.
A three-letter word and there's a Z in it.
Oh, he must be doing the Dutch version because there's a J.
Yeah.
Speaking of not spelling correctly, I looked today on the internet because I had my brakes done on my car, and I type in on Google Maps.
Subaru.
Yeah, right. I type in on Google Maps. I put it in the zip code where I live, and then I put in the little window there. Brakes, right? Oh, and I get my brakes done, and nothing comes up. Like, you know, there's no brake shops in Tarzana? I guess it's not spelled B-R-E-A-K-S.
Oh.
Jesus Christ.
God.
Hey,
you're a retard.
I'm standing talking to a girl, and I said, why don't you write your number down? And I'm looking for a piece of paper, and I'm like, you know, thinking maybe she'll have an eyebrow pencil or something.
Right.
And that's what really gives you away. Because she said, just put it in your phone. You're like, yeah. Yes. That was this old joke I was doing. You know, it's something Nipsey Russell taught me.
Give me envelopes to write on.
Wow, those things give you a
I know, man. All right, anything else going on in the news, Archie?
No, but can I tell you something really fast?
Yes, man.
I forgot to tell you this over the break. It was so funny. I think L.A. is officially a small town.
What?
Because I got a call from my dad's wife, lovely woman, Susan, not yelling at me, but overly concerned, saying, call me right back. I heard there's something wrong. I'm like, well, what in the hell could this be? So I call her back. She goes, hi, what's wrong with your car? I go, what are you talking about? She goes, don't, you know, BS me. You know, what happened? I'm like, Susan, I promise you, I have no idea what you're talking about. So she keeps, you know, grilling me like we're on, you know, SVU. And I keep telling her, I don't know what you're talking about. Well, a mechanic friend of hers heard us talking about the, oil change.
Oh, you're not changing the oil in
from
your car?
Like a while back and ratted me out.
Oh, man.
Yeah. I said, Susan, don't believe everything
what
you hear for God's
rat's
sake.
Ass. The rat.
Whatever happened to real men?
Yeah. Well, Gina had not changed her oil in her car for 2 years. Mm. Yeah. I think it was 35,000 miles.
Oh,
it was more than that.
She needs to be ratted up.
Yeah. And you know what Gina said? So, how often you change your oil? I think your response was, you're supposed to change it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Didn't know that.
But well, over the break, I did it myself. Thank you very much.
Look at you.
And I made the little funnel.
No.
Yes. God. And I even figured out which oil to put in.
Uh-oh.
I think it was a WD-50.
Good for you.
And I put two bottles in. And that's my story.
Right. Hey, Tim.
Usually called quartz, but...
What?
Two bottles.
Where are these kind of women?
I don't know. There's one right there.
That's amazing.
What?
You can't even get chicks to make a reservation. Chicks now, fine chicks don't do nothing.
It was fun. It was really fun.
That's great, Gina.
And I felt really good about it.
Excellent. All right, Gina, what else in the news?
That's what's happening.
All right,
Tim.
The news with Gina Grad, everybody.
The news with Gina Grad.
It's just another Manic Monday, Tim.
Give us 8.5 minutes, and we'll fill it with words.
All right, folks, don't forget to sign up for that big poker tournament coming up on January 15th. Go to 971fmtalk.com and sign up. Again, it's free to get in. If you sign up and you're selected, it's free for you to get in. You're going to have free food, and there's going to be about 300-400 people playing in it. $6,000 worth of prizes they'll be giving out. It's always a great tournament. A lot of listeners show up. A lot of old friends show up, and... Arsenio Hall is going to try to get that.
Hey, man, if one of the prizes is a woman who can change her own oil, I'm there.
Yes.
That's amazing.
All right, 971fmtalk.com. 971fmtalk.com. Sign up. It's under the contest page. And it is the Tim Conway Jr. Show with Arsenio Hall. We're live on 97.1 FM Talk.
Maybe I can discuss it over a dance with you when I'm
righty, welcome back, everybody. It is the Tim Conway Jr. Show live on 97.1 FM Talk with Arsenio Hall.
You go, girl.
Hey, you
Arsenio,
go, dog.
Arsenio, please. Don't forget to sign up for our tournament. And the only reason I'm mentioning it so much is because people get pissed off when they say, hey, why didn't you talk about it on the show? So I'm talking about it. It is going to be a great tournament. Gina Grad will be down there. You can autograph from her. Teresa Strasser. Randy Wang will be there. Myself. Trying to get Arsenio Hall down there. And essentially, excuse me, if you've never been to the Commerce Casino, it's located off the 5 freeway, just off the 710. Between the 710 and the 605. Close to the 710. And, yeah, south of the 710, north of the 605. You can't miss it. But it is absolutely beautiful. It's a great big casino. They have 250 card tables there. And we're going to take about 30, 40, or 50 of them one night up in the big sky room there and play this poker tournament that is going to be outstanding. So anyway, you got to sign up and make sure you do so soon so you have a better shot of getting a seat. It's free to play, free to sign up, you get free food, and they're giving away $6,000 worth of prizes. Who in this economy couldn't use some extra dough? So 971fmtalk.com. 971fmtalk.com. All right, now this happened up in Oregon. I don't know the people that it happened to. This is not a family, it's not a friend. But I read about this in one of the local papers up in Oregon. All right? And you tell me what you think happened.
Okay.
Okay. This happened a couple of days before Christmas. There was an altercation. Mm. There were three people in the house.
Okay.
The kid, the 5-year-old girl, was misbehaving.
Gotcha.
And the mother yelled at the girl, and the girl, like, pushed at her mom. Mom slaps the kid in the face.
Okay.
Dad sees this.
Did the girl make contact, by the way?
Yes.
Okay.
Little girl made contact.
Okay.
But she's only 5. Push the mom. Mother slaps the kid in the face. The husband sees it and slaps the woman in the face and knocks her down. She breaks 2 ribs.
Uh-oh.
Who goes to jail?
Wow. If I'm an officer, I think I have to arrive and arrest the person who threw the first punch.
The 5-year-old?
Yes. Little 5-year-old, keep your hands to yourself. We're taking you away. I guess, you know what? See, I'm kind of cynical and I'm a little bitter and I'm always going to say they probably persecuted the man.
Probably. All right, Gina Grad, in that scenario where the mother yells at the kid, kid pushes mom, mom slaps the kid in the face, and the husband slaps the mother in the face, giving her a black eye and breaking 2 ribs. Who goes to jail?
Who do I think should go to jail?
Who do you think should go to jail?
I kind of think mom had it coming, but I bet dad's going to spend a night in the pokey.
All right, dad. All right, Randy Wang, who do you think they arrested?
I am 100% that they arrested dad.
100%. They arrested the mother.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Even Gina got that wrong.
Even after she had busted the 2 ribs, because evidently the woman hit the kid hard enough to almost knock the kid out, and they said it was a natural reaction of the dad to protect his daughter.
Oh.
And he laid the woman out, and with 2 busted ribs and a black eye, she then had handcuffs on. Well, the ambulance showed up, but she went to jail.
I like that. We're progressing as a society. Take that bitch to jail.
But that was a busy night at the house, don't you think?
Yes, it was. Yes, it was. Wow.
For everybody involved. Now, I was reading this article up in the local paper, and before I, because the writer, the author of this article was great, because he said he wasn't going to tell anybody until the end of the article, and the article ended on the next page.
Mm-hmm.
So you read the story, and he gave you all the details. And he said, all right, guess who goes to jail? And it was on the other page. But I was sure that they would throw the guy in jail or take them both. I thought they were going to take them both. And maybe the kid went to a foster home.
You know what I just learned from this? I like the journalists up there, and I like the police force up there. How much of the houses in Oregon?
They're relatively inexpensive.
Is anything open? I mean, on your street, can I get something? I like it up there.
But I thought that that's really progressive for the cops to arrest the instigator of the whole thing and the one that almost knocked the kid out. Where the father was, it's just his natural reaction, and when you see your kid get hit, is to attack the person, whether it's your wife or whether it's a stranger, whoever attacked your kid.
Absolutely.
You know? And haul off on that that person.
Have you experienced that yet? I mean, that incredible love that a parent has for a child where you go crazy when somebody offends or violates your kid in public in some way?
Absolutely. And I even do it on a low level where... When a couple of years ago during Christmas, one of my relatives was holding my daughter, and my daughter was like kicking and screaming because she didn't want this person to hold her. Mm-hmm. And I said, let me have my daughter back. I'll take her. And she goes, no, she needs to learn that, you know, that I'm okay for her to be with. And I said, F you. And I, you know, grabbed her arm and pulled her away from me.
Yeah.
I said, I'm not going to ask you more than once. When I ask for my daughter, you give me my goddamn daughter.
No, I get that. I had a lady. Her when my son was much smaller, we were at Disneyland, and she turned and her ass brushed his face, and I'm like, hey, you know, and I know she didn't know he was behind, but I'm like, it's still a human being, you know, you can't brush your ass on my son's nose, you know.
I feel sorry for kids like that, and also, is the term little people? Is that the term we use?
I use that at home, but my son says it's midget.
Midget.
No, I'm just kidding. It's little people.
Is it little people?
Yeah.
I feel sorry for little people and young people because they are getting the real busy end of a fart.
Oh, absolutely.
You know, when your nose is a-hole high, is that a term? A-hole high? Sounds like a great high school.
I think there's a flatulence committee that actually uses that term.
But if your nose, I mean, your son's nose is a-hole high.
Right.
He's 9.
Right.
My daughter's a little young for that, but in the next 2 or 3 years, her nose will be a-hole high.
You know what happens is people, and by the way, when we say, does somebody fart? They've already experienced the pain.
Well, they've experienced it in a much larger dose.
Yeah.
Because, you know...
Before it disperses.
As a fart, gets bigger and bigger, it, dissipates? Is that the word? And
it's amazing how much you know about fartology.
It evaporates. And we catch it, you know, 3 feet above what they caught it at.
Right.
But they're getting a very condensed... It's almost like, S. I mean, they're really... The condensed... You know, odor of that fart is hitting him bang right in the nose. But if you're a small person, a little person. Yeah. If you're a little person,
Billy Barty,
you go through your whole life like that.
Yeah, yeah. You know? Always at the scene of the crime.
Yeah, I mean, you know, who's the Billy Barty is
Hervé Villechaize, or we can use the gentleman. From
the Mike Meyer movies.
Yeah, Randy loves
him. Yeah. You know what I'm talking about, right?
Little Mini-Me.
Oh, Mini-Me. What's Mini-Me's name?
Vern Troyer.
Vern Troyer, yeah. Vern Troyer probably has to go home and wash his hair every night. You know? I mean, seriously.
And hopefully he'll use that old shampoo called Gee, Your Hair Smells Terrific.
Okay. All right, when we come back, I have a Hollywood couple that you're not going to believe. All right?
Okay.
And I can't believe this person is dating that person. Okay?
Oh, wow. I got to think about this one.
Yeah, when we come back, I'm going to give you the website.
I can't wait. How long is this commercial?
What, CBS? 12 minutes. All right, it is the Tim Conway Jr. Show. Arsenio Hall is with us, and we are live on 97.1 FM Talk.
Don't blame it on the good times. Blame it on a boogie.
97.1 FM Talk.
All right, welcome back, everybody. It is the Tim Conway Jr. Show live on 97.1 FM Talk. Arsenio Hall is with us, everybody.
I'm his little buddy.
Yes. And we are going to tell you again to sign up for that poker tournament. And it's on our website, 971fmtalk.com. And you can see the whole lineup of the station there. And the ratings are doing amazing. So, kicking ass. All right, here it is, folks. Ryan Seacrest.
My man.
He's got himself a playmate. Known in recent years as the co-host of almost every television event known to mankind. Every time you turn the TV on, he's hosting.
Me and my girl shot some video in the bedroom, and Ryan walked out and introduced us. It was amazing. He anything televised, he's on it.
Well, he is now has an unbelievable chick. I mean, he probably makes about, I bet he makes $45 to $60 million a year.
That is a very fair guesstimate.
You're right. Mm-hmm. And he's probably got a beautiful house because he doesn't look like a guy who blows a lot of his money in Vegas.
Yeah, I have I sat in Ryan's crib and had lunch one time. It's a conservative, modest home, but with a lot of garages.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah. Yeah. He's I don't want to disrespect his privacy, but he's a class dude, man, and he has a nice crib.
Yeah, well, he's got an unbelievable girlfriend right now. And I'm going to give you her name, and you can Google her, and we can all see her.
Oh, no, Tim.
We can all see her naked.
Wow.
I'm going to show you where you can see her totally nude.
See, that's
and
a horrible
thing. I know it's terrible to do. I know you and I are very conservative that way, and I'd hate to say that, hey, you guys can see, you know, J-Con, my wife. Here's where you can see her nude. But listen, I mean, that's what you get. When you date a playmate, the whole world gets to see your chick naked.
So if J-Con was a former playmate, you would just expect that I have Googled her. And
oh, absolutely.
Looked. You would know that.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Well, but don't you, doesn't everybody know that? Like, if you're a playmate and a friend of yours, like, let's say Randy Wang is dating yet another playmate. Right?
Yeah. It could happen.
Yeah.
And you knew her name. Mm-hmm. Don't you immediately go home and before you even take your shoes off or get yourself a, you know, whatever you smoke or whatever you drink, don't you immediately Google her?
Yeah. You know, I would
Or out
like,
of respect to him, would you not Google
that's
her?
That's what I'm saying. I would like to think that I could say, yo, out of respect to Tim, I know his girl used to be a playmate, but I'm not going to look it up.
Is that right?
I'm, you know.
Has that ever happened to you?
I would love to see J-Con's areola, but just one, the left one. But I'm not gonna Google this out of
Has
respect.
That ever happened to you?
No.
Where
absolutely
friend-
not. As a matter of fact, women who aren't even famous, wives of friends in Cleveland, I just Google them just in case, you know?
Oh, absolutely. I'm going to give you her name. And I'm going to give you the website where you can see her totally nude.
What's the name?
All right, go to Google. All right, everybody? Everybody ready? You ready in there?
Okay, here we go.
Everybody's at Google?
Okay.
You ready in there, Randy?
Uh-huh.
You
I'm
got
ready.
It in there, Gina?
Ready.
Have you seen this chick yet?
No, I'm excited. This
okay.
will be a big surprise.
First name, Sarah. S-A-R-A.
S-A-R-A.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Oh, by the way. Okay. Before you go to Google.
Okay.
All right? And then go to Images. Click on Images. It says Web, Images, Maps, News, Shopping, Gmail, More. Click on Images.
Okay.
And then right below the box where you put everything in, it says Safe Search is on.
Oh, okay.
Take Safe Search off.
Hey, even if I'm at home, will I have that?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, click on Safe Search. And then go down about halfway, and it says Safe Search Filtering. And the bottom one is, do not filter my search results, damn it.
See, Tim, this is where we crossed the line. We could have looked this girl up and, out of curiosity, checked her out and left a safe search thing on.
Right.
And then we'd be kind of respecting Ryan.
Right. Don't safe search her. You got to take the safe search off.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
Wrong.
And then let's all type in her name.
Okay.
And if you don't have your computer on right now, write her name down. and we're all going to see Ryan Seacrest's girlfriend nude together.
Tim, my genitals are royal blue. Please give me the spelling of the last name.
First name, S-A-R-A.
I got that, I got that.
Middle name, J-E-A-N.
J-E-A-N. Okay.
Last name, Underwood. U-N-D-E-R-W-O-O-D. And then search images, gang.
Oh, no, I just got a nude picture of Blair Under... No.
And then the first one, I think, is the best one. And then double-click on that picture.
Ooh, with that negligee?
Yeah.
That looked like some Victoria's... Well, it used to be a secret.
And then if you click on it again, it expands it, and you can see, you know, what she... what Ryan sees.
Hey, Ryan's a nice guy, and he works harder than any of us, but he don't deserve this. That's sick.
Yes, her name is Sarah Jean Underwood. Now, you think they're hitting it? They gotta be, right? I mean, hey. If you're dating a playmate, she can't be prude on you, right?
Hey, Ryan, if you're listening, I didn't take the filter off, man.
Yeah, you did.
Tim took the filter off, but
no
I didn't
way,
take the
man.
Filter off.
This you got to take the filter off of Google, and that is her, totally nude. Mm. And isn't that weird to say, you know, with technology today that we can do this?
I would almost rather date an ugly chick who used to work at the register in the car wash than to have people with the ability to look at my fine woman in a previous photography gig or something. This is horrible.
How about if? You're dating that ugly chick who works at a car wash, and she's still nude.
Jesus Christ.
She like has some weird, like, porno magazine that she's in. But that is Ryan Seacrest chick right there.
Saw your ex-girlfriend with a fat ass and that big Raul tattoo on her breast.
And that mole with that hair coming out of it.
Yeah. I used to imagine what she looked like when I would go to the car wash.
Now, let me ask you, now everybody that knows Ryan Seacrest, and I don't know if I've ever met the guy or not. I don't believe I have. But if you know Ryan Seacrest, don't you go home and Google his chick immediately? Or out of respect, do you say, out of respect to him, I'm not going to do it?
Wow.
But don't you always have to do it?
Do you ever watch Dancing with the Stars?
I saw when Carole was on it. That's my extent of it.
So at no point have you ever Googled Brooke Burke?
No, but I know who Brooke Burke is, and she's...
She's a beast.
Very, yeah.
She's a beast.
Yeah. No, I think she's attractive.
For those of you south of Wilshire, you know what I mean. She's a beast.
And those of you north of Wilshire, she's really hot. That's the dividing line, I guess.
Yeah,
huh?
Yeah, absolutely.
South of Wilshire? Yeah, man, she's fat.
We'll translate for those. And what my friend means is F-A-T, fat. He's north of Wilshire.
But that is Ryan Seacrest's chick. What a life that guy's got going. He's making $40 to $60 million a year, and he's hosting everything, and he is probably going to take over for Dick Clark on New Year's Rockin' Eve once Dick decides to stop doing that.
Hey, I wonder if Dick Clark ever Googled her.
Oh, yeah. Don't you think?
You think so?
Oh, yeah. Do you think that Ryan Seacrest's dad Googled her?
Now that's the topic. Would your father Google the piece of ass you just walked in the house with on Thanksgiving?
Oh, yeah.
Do you think Jay-Z's father has ever Googled Beyonce?
How about this question for you? How about Sarah Jean Underwood's dad?
Oh, that's ugly, Tim.
Does he Google her? I don't know. What kind of family
I think the
they
stepdad
come from.
Does.
Oh, yeah. But I think everybody does. The family friends? Everybody does.
You know,
she used to probably work at McDonald's or Safeway or whatever. Doesn't the manager of Safeway Google her?
Probably.
You bet.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, that guy's probably Googling her at work.
I think one of the most attractive women on the planet today is, she's a chick on that, I guess she's on My Fair Brady, but they found her on the, Tyra Banks.
Adrian Curry.
Oh!
Yeah.
My man! Thank you.
Not only hot, but smokes a lot of weed.
Yeah, she looks like she might really party. But she's very attractive, very tall. And I saw her on a show where the father was discussing nudity, and because she did a Playboy layout, right, yeah. You know, that's always uncomfortable.
Oh, huh? Yeah.
To now, even tell your dad, I have a Playboy layout.
Yeah, that's why you sort of have to, you know, wait till your dad dies.
Yeah.
To get into Playboy.
And then we don't want to see it.
Yeah. You know? And you know, like you're 48. Yeah. But yeah, it's tough to do to dad. You know, your dad raises you and all of a sudden it's like, nah, he's got to deal with that.
Because dad's friends.
Oh, they all Google him.
Yeah.
They all Google her. But that is, you know, in today's day and age with a computer, like back in the, you know, I don't know, back in the, you know, 60s, 50s, 40s, 50s, 60s.
Mm-hmm.
Even maybe in the 70s, you know, when Playboy was just, you know, they showed a little tiots, but nothing more.
Right.
And you couldn't Google it. Google didn't exist.
I mean, literally 5 years after you do a layout, it could be forgotten if
right.
somebody doesn't have a back issue, as they
right,
call
exactly,
it.
In the garage. But nowadays, the moment everybody knows that Ryan Seacrest is dating Sarah Jean Underwood, it gets out there, and everybody... Millions and millions of guys, maybe even a billion guys, maybe even a, you know, millions of women, you know, those lesbos out there, those leses.
I'm not sure how I did this, but somehow a picture of Randy Jackson nude just popped up.
I think you got to refresh that.
You got to put your
save search back on.
Here's the weird thing. It's Randy Jackson of the Jacksons.
but you know what? I sort of feel like Ryan Seacrest right now. Because I'm looking at the same thing he's looking at.
Well,
I mean, I'm not close enough where we're in contact, but you know, a lot of guys are going to enjoy themselves to Ryan Seacrest
because Ryan gets to actually get close enough to rub Wesson oil on her ass.
Yeah,
look how she's shining.
But also, Ryan has to deal with whatever craziness
and
she brings to the table.
My friend is something we must talk about one day because the finer a chick is. The more stress and drama that comes along with that relationship.
Oh, yeah.
You know?
Absolutely. That's why you want to get the chick with, you know, missing an arm who works at a car wash.
I was just going to say, little ugly ass one arm chick.
Yeah.
Don't sweat you like this chick will sweat you.
No, man. Yeah, you got to get my, if something, God forbid, ever happens to my wife,
mm-hmm.
I'm going to marry a foreigner who's really fat and missing an eye. She's going to love when I come home with even like, you know, baked chicken. She goes, oh, man.
See, that's why.
Come on with KFC. She'll love you.
What's the chick's name that we mentioned earlier that married Paul McCartney?
Heather Mills.
Heather Mills.
Yeah. Now, Heather Mills. Oh, man. One leg. You know, a lot of people don't get that.
Right.
I get it. You know, I get it. And I bet he expected her to be nicer.
Yeah, but you know, before he went into the relationship with her, he had to have probably thought to himself, she lost a leg in an accident, and she's probably really pissed off.
Okay.
And yet he still went into it with her. He still got into it with her.
See, I expected that she would, it would be like, wow, she's the nicest girl in the world. She's a former model.
Right.
She's gorgeous. But since she lost her leg, she's been humbled.
Yeah, I don't know. I think you have to be born with some kind of deformity for it to really sink in.
Yeah.
I think if you're hot and then you know, you get screwed. But anyway, Sarah.
Tim, is there such thing as a really hot chick who's nice and fun?
No.
Oh, okay.
No. This one will be a pain in the ass, too. I recommend Ryan break up with her tonight.
Yeah.
Sarah Jean Underwood.
Mm-hmm.
Sarah Jean Underwood.
Those
check
pretty,
her out on Google.
Beautiful oily legs.
Yes. And take off your safe search.
No.
Mofos.
No.
All right. Arsenio Hall is with us, folks. It is the Tim Conway Jr. Show. We are live on 97.1 FM Talk.
Discos don't open to after dark. And it ain't till 12 till the party really starts. And I always had to be home by 10. Right before the fun was about to begin.
Get complete shows from Adam Carolla, Frosty, Heidi and Frank, Danny Bonaducci, Tom Likas, and more. Just go to 971fmtalk.com and subscribe with iTunes.